Hello and welcome to the Team VLSI channel. In physical design, in continuation with the previous sessions about the various files in the physical design, we are analyzing the files with the examples, various files. So please do like the video and subscribe our channel. Our channel is youtube.com/teamvlsi. So in this series of sessions, we are going to discuss about these files, these various files. We have already covered up to serial number 6 technology file. We have already covered in session 1 and session 2. Today we will discuss about the DEF file, .def file. First of all, we will start about the very basic information about the DEF file. So DEF stands for Design Exchange Format file. So DEF file is used to represent the physical layout of IC in ASCII format. ASCII format means we can read the file, that is, file is human readable. A DEF file is strongly connected with LEF file, so both file are needed to display the physical design. And DEF was developed by Cadence Design System. DEF is usually generated by PNR tool and used as an input in post analysis tool such as extraction tool, power analysis tool. DEF file contains design specific information of circuits and representation of design at any point during the physical design. DEF conveys logical design data and physical design data from or to PNR tool. Logic design data can include internal connectivity, groove information, and physical constraints. Then physical data includes placement, location, and orientation of components and routing geometries. Now we will discuss about the content of DEF file. A standard DEF file may contain following statement or sections. Here order of statement in DEF file is very important. These are the important sections in a DEF file. So first, there is a version, then divide character definition, verse character definition, design, its design name, then technology, its technology name, then unit, die area, row statement, then track statement, global cell grids, VI statement, non-default rules, component section, then pin section, then blockage section, next fill section, special net sections, net sections, scan chain sections, group sections, and begin extension, and finally end of design statement. So each section we will discuss in details in the following slides. Here for the discussion, I will take a sample DEF file and highlight a particular section in each slide which we are will discuss. So for example, here I have taken the screenshot of a DEF file, and it is the beginning of the DEF file. So you can see here version 5.6. so version for the tool which I have generated it, for the specific version of tool, that tool can generate the DEF version from 5.3 to 5.8, and its tool's default version was 5.6. Next, divide character. Divide character statement, it specifies the character used to express hierarchy. When def names are mapped to the to or from the database, and its default value is forward slash. You can see here. Version is 5.6 divide characters forward slash. Next is bus bit character. Bus bit characters specify the pair of characters used to specify the bus bits, and its default value is square bracket. Next is design statement. Design statement it contain the name of your design. Then technology statement. Technology statement specify the technology name of the design in database. So here you can see TSMC. Then I will hidden the its version. Next is die area. Die area in format of lower left x coordinate, lower left y coordinate, and upper right x coordinate and upper right y coordinate. So two coordinate is required for a rectangular die. In case of your die is polygon, then it will contain the coordinates of each corners. Then next, unit, distance and microns, then conversion factor. You can see here, distance, then unit is microns, and conversion factor is 1000. So here you can see that these numbers I have entered in micron is 974 only die height, but it is here showing 974000. Because the die area has multiplied by 1000, as it is conversion factor here is 1000. Okay, so you can see all these are now in nanometer. So next section is your row statement. So it's a general syntax of row statement. Taken from all the syntax from the the def format manual. Here the row statement, there are many rows, but for sample I have taken the 5 rows here. Row statement is written in this form. You can see here, I will explain everything. So first name is your row, then its row name, like standard underscore row and then underscore 1606. It is your row name. Then it comes to site name. So unit is here site name. Then orig x and orig y. Yeah. So orig x and orig y is the coordinate of starting your row. So you can see here, every row is starting x coordinate is 1000 is fixed, that is 1000 nanometer, that is 1 micron. So I have given a code to die separation is 1 micron. So our row will start. Each row will start from 1 micron. That's why it's 1000 is here fixed origin x, and origin y is coordinate of your rows in y axis. So you can see here. It's 1200 difference in every row. You can see here 951400, 952610. So incrementally it is increasing by 1200 nanometer. I will explain why 1200 nanometer here. So it is the coordinate of lower left. You can say lower left coordinate of your row, every row. Then site orientation, you can see here that orientation is N indicates north, and app hash flip south. I will explain the north orientation later in this session only. So next is come do numx by numy. Here numx and numy specify the repeating set of sites that create the row. Okay, so in numx and numy, one value must be 1. Either numx could be 1 or numy could be 1. If numy is 1, then row will be horizontal. Yeah, so for only numx, numx is 8338 here, and numy is 1. So our rows will be horizontal. Next is step, then step x and step y. In this case, step x is 140 and step y is 0. We can explain these numbers with this calculation, like so calculation for number of sites in array. We have for this specific design, we have 5 array. Width is 0.14 micron and height is 1.2 micron. Okay, so let's suppose our core width is 1167.32 and height is 972. Okay, then number of sites per row, will be our core width divided by site width. So it comes 8338. So 8338 sites will come in a row. That's why our repetition is 8338 here. You can see here in a row. So 8338 sites will having 8338 sites space in a row. Then next thing is number of rows. Number of rows will be our height of core divided by height of our site array. You can say it's standard cell height. So 972 is our core height, and divided by 1.2 it comes 810. That's why our total number of rows is 810 in this case. Okay, I think it's clear each and every component of this. Now you can visualize here the row. That is the actual snapshot of the tool. So this is the row, and you can say that this row is north, this is one row, and this is the site. So 8338 rows will come in this way, and 810 such rows will be generated. So if it is north, then next flip south row will generated, and again north flip south. So alternatively, north and flip south rows will be there, because our VDD and VSS is common for two rows. Like if it is VDD lines, then VDD will be shared by this row and this row also. That's why we have to use different orientation. One is north, then it could be south or flip south, but definitely not north or flip north. So general, by default orientation is north, and at our notch here you can see, so north orientation is in this way, and if we rotate this north orientation by 180 degree either in clockwise or anti-clockwise, then this orientation will come, and this is called our south orientation. And if we flip this south orientation horizontally, then this orientation will generate, this orientation will be like this, and this is called our flip south. And similarly, if we north orientation will flip horizontally, then flip north orientation will, this orientation will called flip north. Okay, fine. So row statement is complete. Now move to the track statement. Track statement, we have to generate the track for physical design first, and the routing will be done in the tracks only. So this is the common syntax of tracks: first tracks, then X or Y, then start, do num tracks, step, then space, then layer and layer name. This is the simple example of track statement, tracks. I will explain it. So X or Y, then start. So you can see here direction and start. Y, then it is the start coordinate in nanometer. So specify the direction and location of the first track defined. X indicate vertical lines and Y indicates horizontal lines. So generating a vertical lines, we only need X coordinate. Yeah, and for horizontal, we have to provide the X, Y coordinate only. Start is the X or Y coordinate of first line. Then do num tracks. So this is num tracks is 9739. Num tracks specify the number of tracks to be created, then step and space. So it is the spacing between the two tracks. So next is layer and the layer name, means for which layers this track is being created. So specify the routing layers used for this track. We can specify more than one layer. You can see here the tracks in a physical design tool. So these blue is vertical tracks, and this yellow is horizontal track. You can for vertical tracks, you can this coordinate will be the start coordinate. So it will be it is the X coordinate only, no need Y coordinates. So for example, if we say it's X, then its coordinate is 90 is in nanometer. So from the first track will start from the 90 nanometers, and it's vertical. Do 8352 is a number of repetition of this tracks. Yeah, and next is your steps 140. For every 140 nanometers, this track will be repeated, and number of repetition will be 8352, and it is for layer metal 1. And there are various tracks in similar way. So next is next section is global cell grids. Global cell grids is used by the routing tools mainly to find the congestion and its global cell density. So again, it's this is the general syntax of G cell grids. This is the actual G cell grid statement in the file. You can see here. Then it has two lines only, GCL grid X and GCL grid Y. X is starting in my case minus 200 nanometer, then Y is minus 200 nanometer both, and its repetition is in X direction, means horizontal repetition is X direction start and we mentioned do num column plus 1 here. So if we have to generate 811 Y, it's in vertical direction. In so if we have to generate 811 cells in Y direction, then we have to mention here 812. Then steps and space. Space is 1.2 in both the directions. Then our VI statement will come. VI statement, first VI name, you can see here. Then routing layers, then cut layers. All VI consist of shapes of three layers, a cut layer and two routing or master slice layers that connect through that cut layers. Next section is non-default rule statement, NDR in short we call. So this is the format of NDR, default format. It defines any non-default rules used in the design that are not specified in the LEF file. This section can also contain the default rule of LEF, non-default rule definition for the reference. So here is an example inside example of NDR in your def file. Non-default rule 1, then layer, its width and spacing. It is not the default width and spacing. So if we want to set the non-default rule for any layers, we can specify. Then component section, this is the biggest section, biggest section is your net section generally, it is a bigger section. It defines the design components, their location and associated attributes for every components. In this section we will define its location and orientation. You can see here the syntax of component section, and here we have an example of the component section, like this is the name of your component, this is reference name of the standard cells, then it is the status placed, its location where this cell is placed, and its orientation. So you can see it's flip now, flip north orientation, south orientation, flip north orientation. So it requires your component name, then it's basically its location and orientation. So it is a very big section, and for each and every components used in your design must have its one line statement. You can see here components, these are the components sitting between VDD and VFF lines. These all are components. So it's we mention its component name, then its location we mention only its lower left coordinate. Then it comes pin section. It defines external pins. Each pin definition assigns a pin name for the external pin and associate the pin name with the corresponding internal net name. The pin name and the net name can be same. Yeah. So in pin section you can see here. This is the pin name. Then its net name. You can see here pin name and net name is same. Then direction of pin, either it could be input or output or in out, a use signal, it could be power, it could be clock, then layer, and orientation. Okay, next is blockage section. Blockage section defines the placement and routing blockage in the design. Sometimes we create the blockage blockage section is written in this way in your dev file. Yeah, this is the blockage 7. Its placement blockage, it is in form of rectangular. Yeah, so you can see here 1, 2, 3, there are 3 placement blockage, and it is a definition of a rectangle. So lower left coordinate and upper right coordinate. So and again it could be routing blockage also. So for routing blockage, it is written as layer. Then blockage for which layers, like M1 here, and it's push down means it is for block level blockage only. In top level, this blockage is not applicable. Then it's again rectangle definition. That means area of the blockage. Yeah. So special net section next. This is the syntax, standard syntax of a special net section, and this is the actual section inside your dev file. So special nets defined here. Then net section comes. This is the standard format for the net section taken from the dev user manual, means language reference. Here is the definition of the nets. Now I will summarize. Dev file is used to transfer the design data across the different tools. We can dev out the design in any stage from or to the PNR tool. Dev file along with lev file gives the complete information of design. And main section in the dev file is a row statement, then track statement, GCL grids, VI statement, non-default rules, component section, pin section, blockage section, then special net section, net sections, extension section. I have not explained these things because in my dev file extension was not available. Then group section again, and end of the design. So this is the summary of your dev file. Next, how to create the dev file. So I have an example of dev creation in the IC compiler tool to write the dev. For command is write_dev in IC compiler. Similar command is for your Innovus tool also. So I'm explaining here with respect to the IC compiler. Then there are various switches, and like output, then output file name means, and then version, and you have to define the version unit. You can define the conversion factors, then compressed, you can generate a compressed dev file or uncompressed. If you will not use this compressed switch, then it will generate an uncompressed dev file. Then if you want to write the rows, then you have to mention the rows, tracks, gcl. There are various switches you can see here. Okay, if you skip any switches, it will not write. So there is an option in GUI also, from where you can export the dev. You have to go the file, and there is a menu inside the file. There is a export, and from export you can go to the write dev. It will pop up in the dialog box, and it has the various buttons for means you have to tick for every options here. And you can write the dev. You can also write left from there also. So dev and left you can generate from the tool. Thank you for watching this session. I will continue this session for the remaining files in next session. Please do like this video and subscribe my channel. My channel is youtube.com/teamvlsi. Thank you.